Everything in the world is alive. This is the first lesson. All things come from spirit, universal love and light. In your mind's eye, envision Grandmother Spider. She gathers up life force from the universe and creates a shimmering ball of energy. The energy takes physical form. This and all physical form has purpose and uses its own unique gifts and talents to serve. Imagine a dot in front of you that represents the manifestation of this physical form. When you acknowledge that everything is alive, you learn to listen, observe, and pay attention to all things. Draw a circle surrounding the dot. This circle represents the reservoir of consciousness. The reservoir of consciousness teaches us the second lesson. Since the dot and all physical form is dropped into this reservoir of consciousness, it means that everything is alive, and also everything is conscious. Realizing that all is conscious, just varying by degree, teaches us to respect all living things and to walk gently through life, aware that ours are not the only desires that matter. Draw another concentric circle around the first. This is the third lesson. Everything is meant to move and to change. All there is change. This is the lesson of transformation and movement. Everything is alive. Everything is energy. Energy cannot be created or destroyed. It can only change form. Change is all there is. When Grandmother Spider drops the energy of life into the reservoir of consciousness, it creates waves like a pebble dropped in still water. Those waves affect every other living, conscious thing in the world. People age, plants grow, oceans reshape their shorelines, rivers change their course. We can always count on the fact that everything is always moving, changing, and transmutating in and out of form. Transformation defines us. To fight change is to deny the very nature of life and our being. Now draw two lines bisecting the circles and forming a cross intersecting at the center point you first drew. Because we are all dropped into the great reservoir of consciousness, we are each connected and in sacred relationship to every other life form. We are all connected. This is the fourth lesson. We are all related. We are all in relationship with each other. It is now time to add two more lines bisecting the circle at 45 degrees. Everything is alive. Everything is conscious. Everything is changing. And everything is connected. With the completion of the last lines, you have a spider web. We are all caught in this web. Since we are all caught in this web, each time you move, each step you take, sends vibrations out to the rest of the web. Everyone else in the web knows your movements, and so everything responds. The fifth lesson. The seen and the unseen respond to the way we move in the world. The web is constantly adjusting itself to our presence, our words, our thoughts, and our actions. We are a part of the web, and the web is a part of us. If the world is not how we would like it to be, we should look at how we are perceiving it. How are we moving through it? What are we manifesting with our thoughts, feelings, and actions? Take the time in this meditation to decide how you want to see the world. What are the changes you need to make? As Gandhi said, be the change you want to see in the world. It all starts with us as individuals. It starts within us and radiates out to all that we see, feel, and touch. How can you live differently? What can you leave the same? Imagine yourself in the grandmother's spider web. How do you affect the members of your family, the community, and the world with your thoughts and actions?